Well, it's, they're claiming that they can't meet because they're not going to be in New York at the same time. That's ridiculous. It isn't as if Washington isn't accessible. Have they not heard of the Acela? Or that President Obama would be out there campaigning. Who sets his campaign schedule? If he wanted to meet with Netanyahu, he would. Obviously, this is a snub. I mean, wrapped inside of a joke. That's about the weakest excuse that you can imagine. But for the Israelis, this is a strategic issue. It's a life and death issue. They look around and they see the IAE report from ago, which said that the Iranian nuclear program, far from being stopped by sanctions, is actually accelerating. That the number of spinning of the production of uranium is doubling now inside the facility in Fardo, outside of the city of Qom, in a place that's almost impregnable. They look around and they see that the negotiations that were supposed to be last-ditch negotiations that we saw in Istanbul and Baghdad and Moscow have gone absolutely nowhere. The Iranians haven't even offered anything. They're just snubbing the world. And the world is doing nothing. And lastly, what they've seen, which I think was the precipitating event, is that the Secretary of State and the State Department have said they have no interest in red lines. Now, as some strategists like Anthony Quartersman and others in the U.S. have argued, if there's any seriousness to our declaration that we're not going to let Iran become nuclear, we have to establish a red line. The negotiations are going nowhere. Everyone knows it. The program is accelerating in Iran, and unless we establish a red line, a deadline, that's a signal to the Iranians they can do anything they want. There'll be no response from the U.S. That's why the Israelis are panicked.
But is there a difference, Charles, between a red line and a deadline? In other words, not a date, but an action by which you cross and then the U.S. attacks?
It could be one or the other. It could be a date. If you're not going to offer anything in negotiations, which they haven't, we're going to have to act. Or you say, if your enrichment reaches a certain capacity, which they are rapidly achieving. But if you don't establish any line, any what it is that we are trying to prevent and when, then you are telling the Iranians in the world we're not serious. And for the Israelis are saying, either have a red line, then we'll trust you, or at least allow us to defend ourselves, but don't do no red lines and give us a red light, because in that case, Israel is entirely